time to time, admittedly, a fair amount of knuckleheaded behaviors. If you're looking for a beer and a beating, Glasgow will happily provide it. The toughness thing is no joke. If you've ever tried to choke a small Glaswegian into unconsciousness, as I have, long story, let me tell you, it's like wrestling with an angry fire plug. It's nearly impossible. Also, it hurts. Access to guns is extremely difficult here. So Scottish hoodlums, unable to dispatch their victims with the kind of speed and efficiency as we enjoy in the good old USA, has had traditionally to resort to the knife to do its maiming and killing. The old country way, one person at a time.
A stabbing might not get more than a few lines down the column in the Glasgow papers. Because in this city of violence, ordinary stabbing is hardly news anymore.
Where knife violence is an affliction, there must be a cure. Meet Mark Davies. He began his career working as a bouncer in some of the East Side's toughest drinking establishments, where he had plenty of opportunities to hone his skills. Now he runs Tactical Edge, teaching close combat and knife defense to UK special operators and security companies. Come at him with a knife? The overwhelming likelihood is that it will soon be hanging out of your ass.
Generally, these courses start, come at me with a knife, and a guy comes at you like it's Friday the 13th. Yeah. And pretty much nobody outside of Friday the 13th, in my experience, has ever come at anyone with it like this. If someone does come, they're rushing at you and with multiple, in a manic frenzy of multiple jabbing or slashing movements.
Yes, your attacker has been affected by adrenaline. In such a state, the forebrain has started to shut down. Yeah, so they're no longer really capable of cognitive thought. So you tend to get these repeated lines of attack. You know, if they're going for the stomach, it tends to be a sewing machine kind of action.
Is your first order of business deflecting or getting the damn knife away from them?
Right. I'm either going to gain control of the weapon or go to a returning blade technique where I gain control of the weapon and return it to sender.
Right.
Yeah.
Show me.
Okay. The thing about knife defense is there's no magic bullet. Any technique can fail. Any technique can go wrong. And if there's multiple opponents, that can get a bit difficult as well. Yeah, that sort of thing, yeah?
Right.
So, if we've got the knife held up close, okay, yeah? So I'm going to clap, pull, hit. Right. Now I'm going to force this thing back into your sternum repeatedly, what we call the woodpecker.
Right.
Yeah? Okay. So you know, two hands on, hit first, brute, back and forward.
Right.
Charge. That's it. Charge. So, ATM mugging. Okay, I'm going to pin your hand to me so I own the weapon.
Right.
And I'm going to slap backwards into the groin.
Yep.
So I'm going to hit, come up, grab.
Yep.
Now I'm going to introduce point A with point B.
Oh, yeah, that's us.
Now, when I do that a few times, it's like taking a baked potato out of the microwave. It's going to be really hot. You're going to let go. So bang, 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 bang. And it's a little bit more close in and surreptitious, and everybody doesn't see it, yeah? So clear the weapon, just shift it to the side, knee him in the balls, straight under, wah! Return to sender.
That was an educational
prompt.
Really enjoyed that.